everybody. We are live from the tree. I'll take that as a win. We saw a deer, we saw a buck in New Hampshire. So good morning. New Hampshire muzzleloader. Morning number two. New Hampshire muzzleloader season 2022. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Andrew Moncrief here, live from the tree stand in No Deer, New Hampshire. Morning number three, New Hampshire muzzleloader. I saw one doe.
First day out, New Hampshire rifle.
Shot a really big New Hampshire deer.
Look at that thing.
Oh man.
That thing is stud, man.
Morning. Howdy, everybody. We are live from the tree. The set we hung yesterday. It is cool this morning. Like, I don't even have my stuff that I should be hunting in ready. Like, it's still packed away from last year, but it's cold. It's high 30s. We're up here high on a ridge. The set we hung yesterday, there's been a ton of bucks, just deer in general, using this pinch point. It's gonna be a great morning. It's gonna be a good morning.
After the sighting of the buck on September 17th, our encounters seemed to dwindle. Like for most, life had its way of making me prioritize my time with work and family obligations. Because of this, we didn't find ourselves in a tree as much as we would have anticipated through the rest of September and October. With a little luck and a lot of patience, we knew that our homework had been done, the stage had been set, and the opportunity would soon present itself on one of the mature New Hampshire giants that we were after.
Just about shooting light, September something. I don't know, what are we, 23rd, 24th? Saturday morning. Cold front blew in yesterday. We're up here on the ridge where we sat last Saturday morning. Saw that little buck down below us, so. So this is Bailey and I sit number four together, two times for bear, two times for deer. We didn't see nothing this morning. Now, so we're gonna pack up our stuff, get the heck out of here. Keep an eye on the cameras and the weather, and we will be back in the tree, bringing it to you. As soon as we feel like it, I guess. So, let's go pack up. That is October 27th, up in a tree. I haven't hunted in a month, so it's like crazy to me. It's almost November, but we've had really warm, rainy weather. First good cold front we've had in a couple weeks blowing in right now. 2 days before New Hampshire muzzleloader season. It's Thursday. It opens Saturday morning. But love to get an opportunity to shoot one of these before gun season comes out. That's they're both really nice deer. Old deer. One's 5 or 6. The other one's 9 or 10. A lot of history with both of them. So.
Obviously, didn't see any antler tonight, but we had 3 does out in front of us for, I don't know what, hour and 45 minutes.
Yeah.
So it was a good night in New Hampshire. We saw 3 deer, so just seeing a deer up here is good. Got tomorrow, and then the next day is muzzleloader. We'll check the wind, see what happens, and we might be back there tomorrow night. If not, going to lay off, and we'll have a muzzleloader in our hands this weekend, and I think just about everyone's hunting, as far as I know, so... Busy couple weeks coming up. Lots of us have vacation, and hopefully we can bring you some awesome footage in the woods of New Hampshire, Mass, New York, wherever the heck else we feel like going.
Opening morning of New Hampshire muzzleloader. We have a huge swamp down here below us, and there's multiple big mature deer in here. Two that I'd really like to see. One more than the other out of those two. You know, it's a really good travel corridor. We got hardwoods up above us 50 yards, so it's a really good transition to cover as well. And they just like to skirt right along here. Sun's coming. wind's doing whatever the heck it wants to do. It's blown every direction since we got in here. Right now it's a west wind. I got nothing, dude. It's freaking hot. I literally just happened to see her flick her tail.
It is, I don't even know the date. I'm so bad with this. 13th?
13th.
13th of November. Flew in last night, was out west, mule deer hunt. Went pretty well. First day out, New Hampshire rifle. First day of New Hampshire rutcation for me. So we have a cold front blowing in right now. Gonna go sit a food plot, low impact. It's rainy, it's just starting to stop. What is it, 1 o'clock? 12:30, 1 o'clock. It's gonna be an extended afternoon sit.
No dice, we're going. Excuse train number two as you go back to revert to number one, the wind's swirling. But there's like 4 or 5 minutes left to legal. The wind's picked up and it's swirling. We're gonna go down and get the heck out of here and go sit the old swamp trail in the morning where we sat in this loader a couple times. We made it in. It's just getting daylight. Wind's blowing really good up on the top here. We're down in the swamp stand where we sat. What, we sit here 2 or 3 times muzzleloader. It's a really good spot. It's a good travel corridor. I don't really have much else to say other than it feels like deer season. I got my warm clothes on. I feel like the Michelin man. So we're gonna grunt, we're gonna rattle, we'll use that plastic cam call, and we're gonna sit, and we're gonna wait, and probably sit and wait some more, but anticipation's high. So that's all I got to say, Bailey, nothing else.
I was gone, obviously, last week, out west hunting, shooting a mule deer, so I gotta get caught up on some stuff, and this wind is hammering even down here in the swamp, so this will be probably the only day we don't sit all day. We got snow coming in 2 days. Gonna get caught up on stuff today. Work. And the rest of the week is gonna be hammering again. So if I had to pick a day to get stuff done, it would be 4 hours midday today. So I'm gonna get undressed because I'm bundled up, and we're gonna climb down and we're gonna hike up a hill. Take a left, go straight, go up another hill, get to the truck because we're way down in here. So, incredible day in the house, working and napping. Bailey napped, I didn't. I got 10 minutes. Super late, it's like 2:45, 2:30. What time is it, Bailey? Did we look?
Well, it's probably past 2:30 at this point.
Yeah, so 2:45, we're gonna be in the stand after 3. Shooting lights 5. Got a good northwest wind on this side of the mountain, so yeah, I don't know, whatever. We're gonna go out there, we're gonna sit. But it's, I'm glad we didn't sit all day today.
Yeah.
Temperatures are plummeting tonight. It's gonna be down to like 15. North wind 2 to 4 tomorrow. So we got a decent little hike in tomorrow. Gonna bring an extra stand for Bailey. A lot of daylight deer, a lot of daylight bucks. One of the shooter bucks was in there 4 days ago in daylight. And we have the right wind to be in there. Gonna wake up really early, but might be a mute point because we might kill one tonight. So I don't know why I'm talking about tomorrow's plans, because the plan tonight's to kill one. So see you guys in the tree.
I don't know, it's the afternoon. It's about 2 hours left of daylight, hour and a half of daylight. We got up here really late, but clover, chicory food plot. Probably the last couple days we'll get out of it because this big heavy frost is coming tonight. Getting down to 15 or 17 degrees, so the deer have been hammering it. There's a bunch of mature bucks that have hit it. None in daylight yet, but November 14th, there's anywhere from 3 to 7 to 9 does that are just cycling in and out, so maybe a boyfriend gets dragged by. There's a bunch of little bucks too. Maybe we can break the cycle and see a deer, because I don't think anyone's seen a deer yet. Brett Ross or me. pretty rough. That's New Hampshire. So we're gonna be quiet, because the wind, it's like dying down, and then you get these gusts like right now, but when it's calm, you can hear everything. So we're gonna sit back, relax, enjoy the ride.
Oh, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me, dude?
We did it, man. We did it. It's split me. G2, right?
Yeah, I think so.
It's a big deer. It's a big buck. I just saw the antlers way outside his ears. I mean, how do you not shoot that deer?
Dude,
it's big.
It's a beautiful deer, dude.
I think it's split G2.
Did you miss him on the first one?
No, his tail was down.
Oh, okay.
But I dropped him on the second one, right?
Yeah.
Dude. I think I hit him low on the first one.
Dude, I let go of the camera because he was standing there and I knew if you shot, I probably would have shook. So I let go, but when you shot, I mean, I still got it all. But like, your arm hit this. But I think we got it all.
It's a big deer.
It's a beautiful deer, dude. Right? Congrats, man. That's
thanks, man.
Awesome.
Thanks. I know the second shot dropped him. I watched him drop in the scope.
Yeah, I had that. I had him running, and you pulled up again, and bang, and dropped him right there.
Did that really just happen? The first shot felt good, but
so
I don't...
The first shot, I didn't see anything, because I couldn't really see through this. You shot, and I just see him turn around and run. I'm like, oh, no. And then he took off running, and you must have drilled him on the second one, because he just flopped.
Did he?
Yeah.
He did flop? I don't even
see
him.
I got it all on video. Wow. He took off running, you shot again, and dropped him.
Well, the thing is, if you think about it, if I would have missed him, he would have been out of there before I could get a second shot.
Yeah. Yeah. Hey, right here, dude. That is awesome. my first ever witness New Hampshire kill.
Yeah. And you know what? That's why it's not a big deal to me not to see a deer, because it happens that fast. So when I get really excited is when I walk up to the deer.
Yeah.
I was more worried about that doe. I knew something was up, and when I saw that other deer,
yeah,
I'm like, I didn't know it was a buck. And then I just see the tines move.
Well, when you said that doe was standing there and there was a deer, but he walked up and he was like hanging out back there, I'm like, mm-hmm. That's weird. A doe usually wouldn't do that. A doe would usually come and stand at like the edge of the plot, mm-hmm. like she was doing. I'm like, it sounds like something a buck would do.
I saw the tines move in the binoculars behind the trees. I don't know what deer it was, bud, but it's this far off its head.
Yeah.
It's a big deer.
It's a deer.
And you know what? As much as I have chased Curly for 5 years, I'm never going to pass that deer. Whatever that deer is a big deer. Pardon my language. It's bigger than I'm being excited about right now.
Dude, there is no problem with shooting that deer, no matter what other...
Oh, no. That's what I'm saying, is that I'm not going to pass a 150-inch deer, which is what I think this deer is. I think this is him. I have his sheds from last year and everything. I don't know, though. I did not wait. I'm like, I will ground check that deer, because that thing is a tank. We did it, man. Thank you for being here.
Dude, thank you. It's been a blast, dude. We've been grinding, and I feel great.
And I tell you what, after the year I've had,
yeah,
with everything.
Yeah, dude, you deserve it, for sure.
Yeah.
You deserve that one.
That feels good.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go get him, man. I can't sit here anymore. Enough of this. We just shot a really big New Hampshire deer. We got Brett. I don't even know who's coming. Is everyone coming?
Probably the whole
gang. The whole gang is coming. It's killing me, because he's like 150 yards right over there. So go change out of this cold weather, sit and stuff, wait for the crew.
Watch
the footage and share the moment with everyone, because that's what it's about, man. So,
I don't even care. Give me a hug, dude.
Dude. Thanks, man.
Hi, buddy.
See ya. Congrats, dude.
Awesome. Hey. Good job, dude. What's up, buddy? Good to see ya. See ya.
Come on, boys. Let me go get this thing out.
Let's go.
You're killing me.
Thank you, Chris.
Oh.
Heck yeah. Look at that thing.
Oh man.
That thing is freaking stud, man.
Look at, he had that thing going. Dude, look at the two on it.
I know.
Awesome buck.
When I tell you I needed this last couple days, man.
Wow.
Yeah, you did.
I needed this a lot.
We all needed this.
Yes. Congratulations, man.
Thanks, guys. Thanks for making the trip.
Oh, man.
What a freaking deer, man.
The hill, and there's another deer not coming.
Yeah. Okay.
And then I'm looking in the binos.
He's just standing there. Okay.
I'm looking in the binos, and I see tines going between a couple trees.
Yeah.
I'm like, okay, it's a buck. And then he gets up, and somewhere up here, he starts freaking pawing and everything.
Really?
I'm looking through binoculars. I'm like, yeah, there's a big buck. I'm like, I don't know what it is. And then on the video, I'm like, is it him? Because I'm like, you know what? I don't care, because this is a big deer.
Yeah,
like,
deer.
Like, that's where I'm like, okay, I'm trying to kill two specific deer, but that deer's big.
Well,
like, that's not just, yeah, I did, but.
Are you sure not?
Okay, just go.
All one, two, three.
I don't know, count for me.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
No, we don't count that one.
Oh, why?
Because it's not big enough. I don't count it. It's another 9.
See that? Those are his antlers. That's the one you found.
Yeah,
that's
you found awesome. This one last year.
Oh.
Look at that. Same buck.
Pretty cool, huh?
Same thing, but big.
Wow, he put on a lot.
Yeah, he blew.
He blew up.
lost that kicker.
And what's your name then?
Like, I don't know how much bigger you can weigh from. Like, he's
mature.
Like, he's like, he's there. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, maybe would have grown 5 inches next year.
Look at that. That's right there, dude.
I know. Look at last year, though. That's almost the same. That's a wrap. Hope you guys enjoyed the hunt as much as Bailey and I did. Totally was not expecting that tonight. We were sitting in a low probability stand where there's a bunch of does, but it's the middle of November. Awesome in New Hampshire deer woods. So if you did like the content, please like, subscribe, share Just Hunt Club on YouTube, social media. Super appreciate it, man. Everybody, Bailey, Brett, John, Fens, my family, everyone that's supportive. It's been a tough year. Needed this one. Thanks, guys. See you next time.